let's start with the analysis of the challenge. The challenge is not just the rising threats, rising powers as a threat to the European Union, but on the one hand, the kind of multipolar world of new kind, where emergent economies are becoming, to some extent, regional powers. On the other hand, the world is also becoming a world of regions. Both the point is relevant, and they are complementary to each other. As the European Union role is concerned, of course, the current debate is about the possible threats. In my opinion, by contrary, there are both threats and opportunities. Yes, there are threats if the multipolar world is an old-style multipolar world based on balance of power, based on principle of non-interference, diminishing the role of multilateralism at the regional and global level. But it's not absolutely evident. We have, by contrary, many evidence of an opposite scenario, that the BRICS are very much interrelated on the one hand with the global institutions like United Nations, WTO, IMF, and so on, and on the other hand with regional cooperation, organized regional cooperation within particular associations of neighboring states. So Europe is interested in strengthening regionalism in the world, not only as a model of regional cooperation. I would prefer reference than model, because model is a little bit Eurocentric concept. Of course, regionalism is growing up according to alternative paths, not as a kind of clone of the European Union. Regionalism is rising up because of domestic reasons, because of particular reasons of in every continent. This is the result of 20 years of research. No doubt the regionalism will be more relevant in the 21st century than in the 20th century. So Europe is a reference in this context. On the other hand, Europe is an actor. As an actor, can or not support regionalism abroad. Sometimes it does by inter-regional relations in SCP, in Rio process with Latin America, ASEM with Eastern Asia. Europe is supporting regionalism abroad. Mercosur, ASEAN, ECOWAS, SADC are strongly supported by the European Union. On the other hand, Europe is a power, has sometimes the tendency to focus on great powers, on bilateral relations between European Union and powers like China, India, and Europe has 10 of these strategic partnerships with powers, emergent powers. This can provoke jealousies by the neighbors. So the challenge for Europe is to avoid cacophony and to try to harmonize multilateral inter-regional relations with regions, block to block, and the individual relation with single powers abroad. That is the big challenge for the years to come.